Hello guys, so in this lecture we'll see one more example based on Taylor series method. Okay, so guys, let us take one more example based on Taylor series method. Let us say this is the given question. Use Taylor's series method to solve dy by dx equals to 2y plus 3 into e raised to power x with initial conditions x not equals to 0 comma y not equals to 1. Find approximate value of y for x equals to 0.1 and x equals to 0.2. Isn't it? That is the given question. So guys, we can see, yes, here this is the x1 value, this is the x2 value, isn't it? So we can say that what will be the h value is what? X1 minus x0. So this is x1 value is 0.1, x0 is 0, so 0.1, isn't it? So we can conclude h value is 0.1, isn't it? Okay, so also what is given? Dy by dx is equals to 2y plus 3 into e raised to power x, that is f of x comma y, that is given to us, isn't it? Now yes, we can say that what will be the y dash? Y dash is given, that is dy by dx means y dash. So that is 2y plus 3 e raised to power x, isn't it? So what will be the y double dash? Y double dash will be 2y dash plus 3 e raised to power x, isn't it? Similarly, y triple dash will be what? 2y double dash plus 3 into e raised to power x. Similarly, we can say that y quadruple dash, that is 2y triple dash plus, we can say that 3 e raised to power x. Yes or no? So yes, we can find the values of these one. We can say that values of all these things, y1, y double dash, y triple dash, y dash and all. So initial we'll taking y naught. Y naught dash will be what? Y naught dash. So y naught dash will be what? That is 2 into y. This y will be what? Y naught only. Plus 3, yes, e raised to power x naught. So put these values 2 into y naught is what? Y naught is given to you, that is 1. And x naught is 0. So after calculating, this value is going to be 5. Similarly, y naught double dash will be what? That is 2y naught dash plus 3 into e raised to power x. So yes, we calculated y naught dash, that is 5 plus 3 into x naught is what? 0. This x naught value is 0. So yes, this value is going to be 30. Similarly, we can find out y naught triple dash, that is what? 2 y double dash, y naught double dash plus 3 e raised to power x naught. So put these values 2 into y naught dot double dash. We just evaluated 13 plus 3 into e raised to power 0. This is going to be 29. Next, y naught quadruple dash, that is what? That is 2 into y triple dash plus 3 e raised to power x naught, isn't it? So we just calculated y naught triple dash. So this value is what? 2 into 29 plus 3 into e raised to power 0, that is going to be 61. So yes, we calculated all these values and so on. So I already told you guys that the fourth up to fourth derivative you can conclude, or you can calculate. After that, you can say you can ignore all these terms because values get smaller and smaller as we proceed. So no need to evaluate further than, we can say that fourth derivative. Isn't it? Okay, so we calculated. Now apply the Taylor series. We can say that. Next one. Yes, by Taylor's series, y1 is y of x1 equals to y0 plus h into y0 dash plus h square divided by factorial 2 y0 double dash h cube upon 3 factorial y0 triple dash and so on. Now initial x1 value is what? That is 0.1. And then y0 is what? 1. H value 0.1 into y0 dash is 5. Plus we can say that 0.1 whole square divided by factorial 2 into 13 plus 0.1 whole cube divided by 3 factorial into 29 plus 0.1 raised to power 4, 4 factorial into 61 and so on. So after calculating all these things, we will be getting y1 value is 1.570, isn't it? So that is the y1. But yes, we can say that x1 is given to you, x2 is also given to you, that is 0.2. Now we need to find out y2, that will be the correct answer. So again, we will be applying Taylor series, isn't it? So we can say that next one, we will be calculating y1 dash, y1 double dash, y1 triple dash. All these values we will be calculating, and after that we'll see, isn't it? So here, remember, y1 is what? 1.570, and x1 is what? That is 0.4, isn't it? Okay, so in the next one we can say that now y1 dash will be what? That will be 2y1, isn't it, plus 3 into e raised to power x1. Now we will be using y1 and x1. So 2 into y1 we just calculated, 1.570, plus 3 into e raised to power 0.1. So after calculation, this one will be going to 6.455. Similarly, what will be the y1 double dash? That will be 2y1 dash plus 3 into e raised to power x1. So just we evaluated y1 dash, that is 6.455. So 2 into 6.455 plus 3 into e raised to power 0.1, this value will be 16.2265. Next one, y1 triple dash, that will be what? That is 2y1 double dash plus 3 into e raised to power x1. We just calculated this one. So this is going to be 2 into 16.2265. plus 3 into e raised to power 0.1. So this value will be, yes, 35.7685. Next one, y1 quadruple dash, that is 2y1 triple dash plus 3e raised to power x1. So this is 2 into 35.7685 plus 3 into e raised to power 0.1. So this value is going to be 74.8525. So be careful while calculating, isn't it? There won't be any calculation mistake, guys, isn't it? Be careful, isn't it? Other than you can see, this is the simple procedure, nothing else. Just calculate carefully, nothing else. Now apply the Taylor series, nothing else. So we can say that by Taylor series, y2 will be what? That is y value at x equals to x2. That will be y1 plus h into y1 dash plus h square by 2 factorial into y1 double dash plus h cube upon 3 factorial y1 triple dash plus h power 4 divided by 4 factorial y1 quadruple dash and so on. Isn't it? Now just substitute the values. X2 value is what? 0.2. So y1 is what? 1.570 plus h value 0.1 into, that is 6.455, plus we can say that 0.1 whole square divided by factorial 2 into y1 double dash is 16.2265. next one, 0.1 whole cube divided by 3 factorial into y1 triple dash, that is what? 35.7685 plus 0.1 whole raised to power 4 divided by 4 factorial into 74.8525, isn't it? And so on. So after calculating, we can say that this is going to be, yes. So after calculation, you will be getting 2.3029. Yes, that will be the correct answer, isn't it? So I hope this one is clear to everyone, guys. So that's all about, we can say, that numerical solution of ordinary differential equations. Thank you so much, guys.